This is Anurag Patiria and welcome to this new lecture on quantum phase estimation. So what does a quantum phase estimation do and why are we studying this? Quantum phase estimation is a very important algorithm, and actually it's not an algorithm, it's just a technique which is used in many algorithms for calculation of different values. So in this lecture we will study what it actually does. And we will continue this lecture with the Shor's algorithm. So what is Shor's algorithm? Shor's algorithm is Shor's algorithm uses quantum phase estimation on a different problem. So phase estimation solves a single problem, and then we use this technique in the Shor's algorithm to find a solution for a different problem. Okay. And it's a very well known problem, so it can actually break RSA codes, and if you know RSA then you will love the beauty of the Shor's algorithm. So let's first start with quantum phase estimation. What quantum phase estimation does is given a unitary operator u, the algorithm estimates theta. So suppose this is a unitary operator, this is an operation, and here psi is an eigenvector and e to the power 2 pi theta is the corresponding eigenvalue. This is the eigenvalue, this is eigenvector and this is the unitary operator. Since u is unitary, all of its eigenvalues have norm 1, so norm of this value is 1. Now this is the circuit of quantum phase estimation. Let me zoom out. Okay, so the circuit is, these are n 0 qubits and this is the our given eigenvector, so given state of it. We have put a Hadamard on all of them. Okay, then this bit rotates. This is a unitary, right? So this is actually a rotator. Okay, this bit with 2 to the power n minus 2 and the 2 to the power 0. So what is actually this is doing? It is reverse rotation. So this rotates this. Now we put a QFT transform on these qubits and then measure it. So what did this what does this do? This put the phase value on these qubits and produces an output of 2 to the power n theta. So we know the 2 to the power n value, right? So if we have n values, then 2 to the power, so for 10 it is 2 to the power 10, 1024, and the measured value will be divided by 2 to the power n. So the theta is calculated. The quantum phase estimation algorithm use phase kickback to write phase u, phase of unitary u in the Fourier basis to the t qubits. So in these t qubits we have written our phase. We then use the inverse QFT to translate this form from the Fourier basis into computational basis. So this is actually a kind of Fourier transform, then this is inverse. So we have converted, written this into these t qubits, applied a QFT inverse and then measured them. So we have got this value. Now how does this happen? We remember that in Fourier basis the topmost qubits completes full rotation when counting between 0 to 2 to the power t. So if you remember the earlier lecture, then if we have 4 qubits, let me, okay, so what we do is we have 4 qubits, 0, 0, 0 and 0. For if we have this as the 0 value, then it will count till 15, right? So 1 1 1 1. We know that this in a complete 2 to the power n, this qubit in Fourier basis rotates its complete in the Fourier basis. This rotates one time, this rotates 4 times, this rotates sorry, this rotate 8 times, this rotate 4 times, this rotate 2 times, and this rotate 1 time. So that is what we know right now. Okay, so now what we will do, when we use qubit to control U-gate, the qubit will turn proportionally to phase e to the power 2 pi theta. Now we can use controlled U-gates. What are these gates? These are controlled U-gates. So this is controlled by these states, and these qubits, T qubits, are turned according to that. Now, to repeat this rotation on appropriate number of times, so by applying QFT transfers into the computational basis, so we have actually got enough points to get an intuition, I guess. Now we will study the mathematical foundation. As the mentioned above, the circuit estimates the phase of unitary operator U. That we know. So what is the setup? According to diagram, we will see. Psi is one set of qubit registers. Okay. The additional set of n qubits form the counting registers, which will store 2 to the power n theta. Okay. Now, we apply superposition. How superposition is applied? The Hadamard gate that we actually see in that. So if 0 is converted to Hadamard, then we get 0 plus 1. So for n qubits, we get 2 to the power n by 2. I think I should zoom out. Okay. Psi 1 equals to 2 to the power n by 2, 0 plus 1 for n qubits and psi. Okay. So now we apply superposition using Hadamard gate. That we understood. Now, what are we doing? We are applying controlled unitary operations. So, we need to introduce the controlled unitary. So, okay, so controlled unitary operations are to be applied. Now, what does that mean by power? So, that means that these many times we have to apply these controlled unitary operations. And then, the inverse Fourier transform. So what is inverse Fourier transform? Fourier transform converts from Fourier from norm computational basis to Fourier basis. Now what should a Fourier transform inverse does? It should convert from Fourier basis to computational basis, because in that basis we are actually trying to compute or measure. Okay. So exactly result. So for inverse and QFT, both functions are available in Qiskit. You can use them to directly apply. And then the above expression peaks near 2 to the power n theta. So this in the output, when we measure, we will get the highest probability for this x at x equals 2 to the power n theta. For the case 2 to the power n theta is an integer, measuring in the computational basis gives the phase in n-sila register with highest probability. For the case when it is not an integer, it can be shown that above expression still peaks under near x to where with probability better than 40%, and that's a great probability because for all other values will be not very significantly probable. Now we want to know, suppose the unitary operator, example for T gate is a normal unitary operator and which gives a phase for e to the power I pi by 4. So this can be represented at 2 to the power I theta. Here theta equals to 1 by 8. That is very easy. So what we do? We just import whatever is there. Import is done. That will take time. Till now, just a fun fact. Quantum computing is actually growing. So if you want to explore more and more, there's a book of quantum computer science by Merman, and Dancing with Qubits is also great book. But to actually understand quantum computing in a really better way, you should try to go through physics. If you go through physics now, then you will understand that how great the world is. Like, initially this looks like things are happening and just memorize it. No, these are not, because memorization is not the way to understand quantum computing. You need to first get the intuition, how are these things working? This is not the right way. Like how can a probability be zero? The first question comes, how can it be? Because that is straightforward. And that is where we need to break the boundaries of our intuitions that were made on the basis of classical physics, because they are not followed there. Okay, so I was just trying to give a suggestion. So let's just continue. And now we have psi. So quantum phase estimation, we create a circuit. That's, I think, okay to assume. This is 3 qubits, this is our x, this measurement, classical qubits, okay. Now we apply in these qubit Hadamard, that is what we were doing. Okay, so Hadamard is applied. Now we perform a control unitary operations. Qiskit orders its qubits opposite. So Qiskit orders its qubits opposite around the image above. So actually this Qiskit understands this in Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. So that just needs to be understood. I think we'll practice then. Now repetitions is 1. So for counting qubit in range 3, 0 to 3. For I in range repetitions, controlled operation is applied, which is unitary is e pi by 4 and counting qubit. This is very basic operation. Just see. So U1 is applied, U1 is applied, U1 is applied, U1 is applied. And U1, and then you just zoom in. Okay. So U1 is applied to this, U1 is applied to this, U1 is applied to this, U1 is applied to this. Now U2 is applied to this, U1 is applied to this, U1 is applied to this. I think all are U1 only. So U1 is applied to all of them, and this is a repetition. One time applied here, two times applied here, and four times applied here. So you understand that it is actually in reverse, right? So Q0 must be here. Right, in the earlier circuit, if we see, so u to the power 2n minus 1 is applied at q0th qubit. So n to the power 0 once only on the q0th qubit, and on the nth qubit it is applied u to the 2 to the power n minus 1 time. So the same we are gonna do here. For the 0th qubit, we are only gonna apply 1 time, and then 2 to the power 2 to the power 2 time, and the 2 to the power 0 time, 2 to the power 2, 1 time, 2 to the power 2 time. So I think that is enough to understand. And then we are just need to apply a QFT dagger. That is simple. You can just apply it using very simple, and then we can just apply a barrier. Barrier is just nothing but to clarify that we have clear boundaries made. Okay, so here first this unitary is applied, and then this is a QFT dagger operation. This from here to here, and then the measurements are made. Now we run it on a simulator. And we should get some output. And what value should we get? Let's see. It's writing on a quantum simulator. So you can see that we got our output near 001. So 001 means we have got 2 to the power n theta equals to 1. Now we know that n equals to 3. So theta equals to 1 upon 2 to the power 3. This is 1 by 8. And this is exactly the phase estimation. So that is what we actually wanted as the output. Instead of T gate, less U. So now you are saying that this is just for fixed theta. So we can actually find a different angle too. We can make a different operator with this angle. Okay, this is the operation. That is also very keen to observe. Okay, so this is actually a different operation. Okay, so where we continued, we wanted theta equals to 1 by 3 and we want to measure the same. So we use three classical bits, one extra qubit, and then we create a apply Hadamard gates to quantum qubits, prepare our eigenstate psi. Okay, now do the controlled U operation. For that we need to apply, we know that this is angle pi by 3, so 2 by pi 3 we are applying. Then we apply the repetitions, that is actually, so we are just writing this as an operation, then QFT dagger and then the measure. So U 2 pi by 3, 2 pi by 3, 2 pi by 3, 2 pi by 3, this is actually what we have done. This is where we apply the QFT dagger here. And then we measure it. So we measure it along 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1 means 3. And 3 is divided by 8. Okay. So 2 to the power n theta equals to our angle is given. So this is actually 3. 2 to the power n is, okay. 2 to the power n is 3 qubits were there. So 8. And 8 is divided by 3 upon 8. 3 upon 8 is approximately equal to the actual theta. The true value of theta lies between the value we can get from our counting bits. This gives us uncertainty and precision. So this is where the value is near. Solution: to get more precision, simply add more counting qubits. So this is not very approximately correct, right? So we apply more qubits. How many qubits? We apply 5 qubits here. And the repeat the same, and we see that for 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, this is actually 11, and 5 qubits is 11 upon 2 to the power of 5, so 0.34, and this is 0.313, so that's pretty good precision, and we apply it on the real machine, and I think the real machine won't load for enough, but I think you got the intuition. So if this is basically a very basic algorithm, quantum phase estimation. Now what is this doing? This is actually a calculating a phase. Now phase is a very common term in wave, but how does it affect a period finding problem? We will understand it as Shor's algorithm. So I'd like to close this lecture here. You can access this using Qiskit textbook and open in IBM Quantum Experience. I hope that this lecture has been helpful for you, and let's meet in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.